An Italian's Virgin Escort Novel Audiobook. Chapter 1. Sienna Point of View. Sienna, you need to come here fast, as our CEO is on his way here. I received a call from my team head making me run through the crowded footpaths of New York City. People are always busy here. The city is lively with people buzzing around at the daytime, and it is lit with many lights. Like stars have graced their beauty on earth. At the night time, I love staying in this city in spite of the problems and scary nightmares I am going through. I hurried towards the road, waited for a walk signal to cross the road. I should be in the office by now, and it takes 10 minutes walk from here. Wish CEO sir doesn't arrive so quickly. Just as I saw the walk signal on traffic lights, I started crossing road but stopped suddenly, looking at a shiny luxurious SUV standing there in traffic. I walked towards the car and knocked at the driver window. He rolled down the black tinted window and narrowed his eyes towards me, eyeing me up and down. You need to off the engine while in traffic or the car is at a stop, sir. We cannot deprive our future generations with gas, petrol, diesel, right? Please do off the engine next time, sir. It also prevents some of the pollution too, I said in a small tone, not wanting to offend him or the owner who is sitting at the back seat. I leaned back after telling him what I wanted to and looked half open window of the back seat of the car. I went towards the owner to tell my apologies for wasting their time. When I saw those eyes, those deep sea blue eyes which are like crystals shining at every flicker of light, they are a very interesting and unique color that I found myself looking at them interestingly. I could only see his eyes from the little opening of the window, but I can tell he must be looking like a beauty god. His eyes gave away that much that he might be in his late 20s, I assume, looking at his young, clear eyes narrowed towards me with rage. I know that look, and I learned few of them all these 4 years from the place I'm currently staying. When someone who thinks they are as mighty as God gives that look, it means he is not a fan of taking good advices from people who they think are nothing but beggars before them. I agree that look did shake my legs with fear, but I'm still glad that I could mutter up the courage to give a little advice, and I don't regret it. He squinted on his eyes towards me, and I know he must be gritting his teeth, preventing himself from lashing on me in the public face. I bowed my head in fear and scurried away before I let him hurt me. Why do I do such things? I know I need to maintain a low profile because I have so much to lose. I have too many secrets to risk. But still, I cannot keep my nature-related opinions to myself. I think I have nature-omania. I crossed the road in a speed walk and made a run towards my office. I'm working from 7 months. It is 60 floors glass building standing regally at the center of the heart of New York. Bianchi Interior Designers Inc. I work as an interior design intern in a very famous, one of the top 5 empires in the world, Bianchi Empire. I studied very hard day and night and gained a scholarship in the college. Once I finished the course, I was recruited immediately by my team head into the Bianchi Interior Designing Company. It is one of the biggest companies, providing its services to almost all the main projects in the world. There are more than hundreds of teams who are working worldwide from this company. They own almost all sectors of business in and around the world, and interior designing is just a small part of their vast, well-established empire. And today our CEO, Mr. Leonardo Bianchi, is coming here to discuss about an island project. I did not see him or know how he looks like, but news has its own way telling people about the celebrities like him. Handsome CEO Mr. Leonardo Bianchi is seen in a 5-star hotel spending quality night with a lovely lady. Yet Mr. Leonardo Bianchi is seen with another beautiful model in his arms, and the playboy is still not ready to settle down with a wife even at his 30 years of age. Once I heard about these rumors, news about him from my colleague friend Lia, I made up my mind that I should get into his list of play toys, as he has a reputation of not even sparing his employees. I am not a beauty. No, I am not. I'm a simple person who doesn't receive any attention from others, and that's a good thing for me, because the more I let people in, The more I grant a path for them to know my deep secret I buried and was living with it from 4 years. I have my own problems. So loving or liking someone is not in my book of to-dos. I have few goals and achievements to make. I want to do something for the ladies I live with. I want to provide freedom for them. They are not there on their own choice but on a compulsion and in fear. Most of them are thriving for a life out of it and make a decent life. But once you get into it, there is no out from there. And I'm one of them. I'm one of the escorts living there. I was dumped there like many of them. In an escort house. Precisely. A prostitute house. Welcome to download the Bravonovel App. Read the novel in Italian's Virgin Escort online and get the latest updates.